Good morning to everybody. So already you completed three questions in exercise 7.3. So today we start the question number 4. And that is BE and CF, exercise 7.3. Question number 4. It's given that BE and CF, it is a given triangle for you. A, BC, it is BE. It is F. BE and CF are two equal altitudes of a triangle ABC. Using RHS congruence rule, prove that triangle ABC is an isosceles. What it is given for you? Given that BE equal to CF. Given that BE equal to CF. To prove ABC is an isosceles. So it is enough to prove that either AB equal to AC. You need two sides are equal. Okay. Either AB equal to AC or BC equal to AC. Or whatever. Okay. Otherwise, any two angles are equal. If they ask you to prove that ABC is an isosceles triangle, right? Triangle ABC is an isosceles. What you have to prove? Triangle ABC is an isosceles. So, what is the property of an isosceles? In a triangle, any two sides are equal, then it is an isosceles. Otherwise, in a triangle, if any two base angles are equal, then it is an isosceles. Are you getting it here? Yes. Now, we are going to consider two triangles. What are they? You can consider the triangle BCE and then CBF, because it is given that these are altitudes. So, it is perpendicular to the base. Okay. Okay. Now, in triangle BCE and triangle CFB. Am I right? In triangle BCE. That is BCE and CFB. It is 90 degree. Am I right? It is given for you. That is angle BEC equal to angle CFB equal to 90 degree each. It is given. It is what? Given for you. Then, here BCBC common. BCBC common. That is equal hypotenuse. Otherwise, you can say that. What is that? Hypotenuse. Common hypotenuse. After that, we found two parts. We need one more parts to prove these two triangles are congruent. Now, what it is given? Anything is given? Yes. BE equal to CF, it is given. Therefore, by RHS congruence rule, RHS congruence rule means what? Right angle, hypotenuse and any one side of the triangle. Okay. So, by RHS congruence rule, triangle BCE is congruence to triangle CBF. BCE is congruence to triangle CBF. So, therefore, by CPCT you can say that angle BCE equal to angle CBF. Therefore, by CPCT, you can say that angle BCE equal to angle CFB. This implies that angle C equal to angle B. Angle C is equal to angle B. Up therefore, what can you say? Triangle ABC is an isosceles. So, in a triangle, any two angles are equal, then it is an isosceles. Therefore, triangle ABC is an isosceles. ABC is an isosceles triangle. Are you getting it here? Right? Okay. In the next video, we will discuss the question number 5. Thank you, everybody. Thank you.